Hi, and welcome to Scope Month. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Today is Tuesday, March 14th. Happy Pi Day. We are going to be giving away five 1,000 X-Series scopes, plus a bonus 1,000 X-Series scope, a sixth one, because we forgot to give it away yesterday in the live stream. Since it's Pi Day, we're going to use a Raspberry Pi for today's scope tip. I have a Nixie Tube project I've been working on. There'll be a video for that in the coming months, where I'm using a Raspberry Pi's GPIO pins to connect to a BCD converter that then connects to the Nixie Tubes. So the setup I have a breakout board connected to four of my GPIO pins, and I've connected an MSO cable to each of those four pins. This button should increment my GPIO pins by one in binary each time it's pressed. To debug my code, which I'm not going to post on GitHub to spare you having to deal with my coding, I've hooked up my digital channel 0 through 3 to the four GPIO pins that should be outputting a binary value. So to view those signals, I'm going to turn on my digital channels. And since I'm only using channels 0 through 3, I'm going to turn off 8 through 15. And I'm also going to turn off 7, 6, 5, and 4. Make those a little bigger, and now I'm left with the four channels that I'm actually using. I'm also going to turn off channel 1 because I don't need that. So now when I hit this button, I should be able to see my digital channels changing, which is helpful, but it could actually be more helpful if I could turn on a bus here. So I'm going to go back to my digital channels, hit a bus, and I'm going to turn on bus channel 1 and make sure that is assigned to just channels 0 through 3, so I'm going to deselect 8 through 15. And now you can see I have a binary value displayed at the bottom of the screen, and when I hit the button that should increment this code, I'll start seeing it increment in binary. I can also change the base value to hex instead of binary, and since it's for a Nixie tube, it should only show 0 through 9 when I press this button. I also want to debug my transitions so I can see how long of a period I need to set for debouncing. So I'm going to go back into normal trigger mode, and we talked about this yesterday, so check out yesterday's live stream to see why we're doing that. And then I'm going to set my trigger to be an OR trigger, and I'm going to set just all channels to either edge, and that's going to catch any edges on any of my channels. And now when I press the button, we should be able to see the transitions here. And you can see here it changes from 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6. And you can see that my debouncing was a little too quick and I skipped a number there. So I'd have to go back, check this period in time, how long that transition takes, and set my debounce time for that period of time. I'll do a full project video on this in the coming months with the whole Nixie Tube setup. So make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel so you can see when that comes out. Let's go ahead and draw our 1,000 X-Series scope winners. Again, we're going to draw 6 instead of 5 because we still have one more scope from the Find Daniel contest from last week. So today's winners are Jesuin Lazarte, Andrew Dunk, Mikkel van Damgaard, Sajan Laji, Enrique Sanchez, and Trevor Hobbs. Congratulations to our winners. We're going to start putting winners scrolling along the top by request in the comments. So if there's other things you want to see in these videos, put them in the comments. If there's any scope tips you want me to cover, put them in the comments. I read each and every one of those. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about how digital channels work on your oscilloscope, there's a 2-minute guru video from season 1. The link for that is in the description, and there's a card also. And it talks about the theory of operation behind digital channels. We also have a brand new 2-minute guru video live today about electrical current. Also, make sure you like us on Facebook, check us out on Instagram. You can also follow me on Twitter at Keysight_Daniel. I will see you tomorrow. So this is the room that we've been doing all of our filming in. And I've set up this cutout just to freak people out a little bit. And you'd be amazed how many people have sent me texts and emails. Even the guards walking by at night had just flipped out. Did the cutout freak you out at all, Allie?
It was terrifying, like 10 times.